went to that party last week. It was totally lit.
Yeah, and this amazing thing happened.
Oh yeah? What?
I met this guy, Elijah. He's so charming, and I feel like we really connected, you know?
Wait, Elijah, as in Elijah Miller, the senior? Isn't he the one that's dated like 4 freshmen already?
Yeah, why?
Because you're a freshman, and you're only 14, so I'm pretty sure that's illegal.
It's not illegal to date, though my parents can't know about it.
You're just proving my point, Zoe.
I know, but he was so romantic, and I'm gonna go out with him anyway, so why can't you just give me this one?
Well, if he makes you happy, I guess that's good enough for me.
Thank you for understanding.
So, how are you liking that book?
I mean, it's okay. It's not really my thing, but it's okay.
What do you mean? That's my favorite book.
I know, but it's more your style than mine. I'm more into, like, romance novels.
Well, good thing you're gonna finish it, right?
Okay.
Who's that?
It's just my parents.
Let me see. Just tell them that you're studying with Stephanie and you'll be home in a little bit.
I mean, I don't really want to lie.
Zoe, it's really no big deal. Just text it and be done with it.
Okay.
Hey.
Hi.
Oh, what are you wearing?
What do you mean?
Well, your shirt seems a little tight. Are you sure you don't want to wear something else? The guys might stare.
I mean, I think it's fine.
Well, maybe you could just go get a hoodie or something out of your locker.
Okay.
Hey, girl. We need to hang out. We haven't in ages, and I need you to dye my hair.
Oh, that sounds fantastic. I really need a girl's night.
Great. So, do I need to have my mom let your parents know?
No, they're out of town for the weekend, so it doesn't matter.
That's great. Why do you keep looking at your phone?
Oh, it's Elijah. He keeps texting me, but I've been trying to ignore it.
Is he going to get in the way of our girls' night?
I'm sure he won't mind.
I don't like how controlling he's gotten, Zoe. He never leaves you alone. And I know you think it's love, but I think it's obsessive. Like, are you going to have to ask permission to have a girls' night with your best friend?
No, I'm sure I won't have to.
Really?
No, but maybe I won't tell him.
Okay, but if you ask me, you should break up with him. He's too controlling.
But I love him. And anyways, let's just not talk about guys. It's supposed to be a girls' night, so maybe I'll just turn my phone off.
If you say so. But let's get going. This hair isn't going to dye itself. Come sit down. We never talk anymore.
Hey, Tristan, I'm sorry. It's just that Elijah wants to hang out all the time.
It's cool. I just miss hanging out with my favorite neighbor.
Don't you have a girlfriend that could replace me?
Zoe.
Elijah.
What are you doing?
What do you mean?
You're so clueless.
What's going on?
Why were you flirting with that guy over there?
I wasn't. He's just my neighbor.
That doesn't change anything. You're with me now. I know you've never had a boyfriend before, but I didn't think you could be so stupid. Don't you know that when you start dating a guy, you can't just talk to other guys?
You're being ridiculous, Elijah.
Zoe!
What?
Please don't leave. I love you, and sometimes I just get so scared because you're just so hot that I feel like other guys are going to try to take you from me. Please forgive me.
Oh, I love you too, Elijah. Stephanie.
Oh, it was Elijah. He said he wanted to talk to you. I told him you were fine and you were dyeing your hair too. He was mad when I told him it was a girls' night and he started yelling, so I had to have my dad make him leave.
You shouldn't have done that. Now he's gonna be really mad next time he sees me.
So what? He can get over it. He has to let you live a little too.
But I really love him and he's a nice guy and great fun when he isn't mad.
Do you hear yourself, Zoe? You're afraid to make him mad? Has he hit you before?
I mean, not really.
I know you love him, but that's not the point. You don't deserve to be treated this way. He should respect you and the things you want to do. And he should trust you to be with other people, too.
It's not that bad most of the time, and I'm helping him deal with his temper.
Honestly, I think that's a job that should be taken on by a counselor or even a therapist. As long as you stay with him, he might not realize what a problem he has.
Maybe, but I'm not ready to break up with him yet.
Well, whatever. It's your decision. Just promise me that next time you meet up with him, it'll be in a public place. Because if it's in public, then he can't hurt you.
I told you he didn't hurt me, so why can't you just shut up about it? You know what? Find someone else to hang out with. I'm leaving.